Participants from around the world, namaste. Congratulations to the organizers for successfully organizing VivaTech in this difficult time. This platform reflects the technological vision of France. India and France have been working closely on a wide range of subjects. Among these, technology and digital are emerging areas of cooperation. It is the need of the hour that such cooperation continue to grow further. It will not only help our nations, but also the world at large. Many youngsters saw the French Open with great enthusiasm. One of India's tech companies, Infosys, provided tech support for the tournament. Likewise, the French company Atos is involved in project for making the fastest supercomputer in India. Whether it is France, Capgemini, or India, TCS and Wipro, our IT talent is serving companies and citizens all over the world. Friends, I believe where convention fails, innovation can help. This has been seen during the COVID-19 global pandemic, which is the biggest disruption of our age. All nations have suffered loss and felt anxiety about the future. COVID-19 put many of our conventional methods to test. However, it was innovation that came to the rescue. By innovation, I refer to innovation before the pandemic, innovation during the pandemic. When I speak about innovation before the pandemic, I refer to the pre-existing advances which help us during the pandemic. Digital technology help us cope, connect, comfort, console. Through digital media, we could work, talk with our loved ones, and help others. India's universal and unique biometric digital identity system, Aadhaar, help us to provide timely financial support to the poor. We could supply free food to 800 million people and deliver cooking fuel subsidies to many households. We in India were able to operationalize two public digital educational programs, Swayam and Diksha, in quick time to help students. The second part, innovation for the pandemic, refers to how humanity rose to the occasion and made the fight against it more effective. In this, the role of our startup sector has been paramount. Let me give you India's example. When the pandemic hit our shores, we had inadequate testing capacities and shortage of masks, PPE, ventilators, and other such equipment. Our private sector played a key role in addressing this shortage. Our doctors adopted telemedicine in a big way so that some COVID and other non-COVID issues could be addressed virtually. Two vaccines are being made in India and more are in the development or trial stage. On the government side, our indigenous IT platform, Arogya Setu, enabled effective contact tracing. Our COVID digital platform has already helped ensure vaccines to millions. Had we not been innovating, then our fight against COVID-19 would have been much weaker. We must not abandon this innovative zeal so that we are even better prepared when the next challenge strikes. Friends, India's strides in the world of tech and startup are well known. Our nation is home to one of the world's largest startup ecosystems. Several unicorns have come up in the recent years. India offers what innovators and investors need. I invite the world to invest in India based on the five pillars of talent, market, capital, ecosystem, and culture of openness. Indian tech talent pool is famous across the world. Indian youth have given tech solutions to some of the world's most pressing problems. Today, India has 1.18 billion mobile phones and 775 million internet users. This is more than the population of several nations. Data consumption in India is among the highest and cheapest in the world. Indians are the largest users of social media. There is a diverse and extensive market that awaits you. Friends, this digital expansion is being powered by creating state-of-the-art public digital infrastructure. 523,000 kilometers of fiber optic network already links our 156,000 village councils. Many more are being connected in the times to come. Public Wi-Fi network across the country are coming up. Likewise, India is working actively to nurture a culture of innovation. There are state-of-the-art innovation labs in 7,500 schools under the Atal Innovation Mission. Our students are taking part in numerous hackathons, including with students overseas. This gives them the much-needed exposure to global talent and best practices. Friends, over the past years, we have witnessed a lot of disruption in different sectors. Much of it is still there. Yet, disruption does not have the mean despair. Instead, we must keep the focus on the twin foundation of repair and prepare. This time last year, the world was still seeking a vaccine. Today, we have quite a few. Similarly, we have to continue repairing health infrastructure and our economies. We in India implemented huge reforms across sectors, be it mining, space, banking, atomic energy and more. This goes on to show that India as a nation is adaptable and agile. Even in the middle of the pandemic, and when I say prepare, I mean insulating our planet against the next pandemic, ensuring we focus on sustainable lifestyle that stop ecological degradation, strengthening cooperation in furthering research as well as innovation. Friends, the challenges our planet faces can only be overcome with a collective spirit and a human-centric approach. For this, I call upon the startup community to take the lead. The startup space is dominated by youngsters. These are people free from the baggage of the past. They are best placed to power global transformation. Our startups must explore areas such as healthcare, eco-friendly technology including waste recycling, agriculture, new age tools of learning. Friends, as an open society and economy, as a nation committed to the international system, partnership matters to India. France and Europe are among our key partners. In my conversations with President Macron, in my summit with EU leaders, in Porto in May, digital partnership from startups to quantum computing emerged as a key priority. History has shown that leadership in new technology drives economic strength, jobs and prosperity. But our partnership must also serve a larger purpose in service of humanity. This pandemic is not only a test of our resilience, but also of our imagination. It is a chance to build a more inclusive, caring and sustainable future for all. Like President Macron, I have faith in the power of science and the possibilities of innovation to help us achieve that future. Thank you. Thank you very much.